गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन लेसन नंबर 8 हिस्ट्री विमेन कास्ट एंड रिफॉर्म पार्ट 1. नाउ सी एज इन इंटरेक्टिव सेशन आई टोल्ड यू दैट सीबीएसई हैड रिड्यूस्ड 30% सिलेबस, सो आई रिड्यूस लेसन नंबर 6 एंड लेसन नंबर 7, बट लेसन नंबर 8 9 10 दैट इट वुड बी वेरी हेल्पफुल टू यू इन 9th स्टैंडर्ड एंड 10th स्टैंडर्ड. दैट्स व्हाई I have started this lesson number 8. Now you have to read this lesson whenever which part that teacher explained it, that you should have to read not only of history, that other subjects also there. But it now civics also, that unit 2 I have reduced it, and geography last lesson, 6th lesson also. Means you have such a less syllabus, you should have to do a proper study. Understood? Here this for lesson. Name of the lesson is Women, Caste and Reform Part 1. Now, have you thought about the 200 years back, how the children's lives were there? No, their lives were totally different. But nowadays what's that, the girls can go to school, now girls go to the school with the boys, they can take education with the boys also there. Now, against what, they can complete their school education, they can go to the college, they can go to the university, then they can do the job also, and whenever they become adult, they can choose their husband also. If any community, if any religion is there, then the women have right, they can choose their husband also. Understood? Or like for all men, that women also got right to vote. Means they also can cast the vote. Again, they can stand for election also there. Again, whatever the things the men do in the society, all the things the women also nowadays doing, that is nowadays. But before 200 years back, it was not like that. Now see, nowadays if any discussion is debate is there, the women can take part in that. But before that, these facilities the women were not getting. Okay. Even the men could marry more than one time, two time, three times also there. Understood? But if the women became widow, she were not getting right to again remarry. Understood? Now that women mostly they were not getting education, they were denied education. Again, whenever the husband died, that last year also I told you about the cruel sati system was there, and these women were burning with the husband's funeral pyre there. Understood? Whenever the husband died, this at that time the women were also going to sati, that sati system was there. Even the women were not getting any type of wealth from the father's her father's family. Understood? Means they had restricted that one. This was the discrimination was there. But nowadays the women get share of the father's wealth there as the men get it like that. Nowadays somewhat the good condition of that, women getting education right, everything. But only this discrimination was there in the society? No, another discrimination also was there. That which was that discrimination? That was the caste discrimination was there. Now the Varna system you have read in 6th standard also and 7th standard also there. That these 4 Varnas were there. That Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya and the Shudra. 4 Varnas were there. Now the Brahmin and the Kshatriya's people, they were thinking that they having upper caste, and another peasants, barbarians, they were Shudra, and those who were doing the trading there, that was the Vaishyas. Means the 4 Varnas were there, and some peoples were there, they were that high caste people, treating them as a low caste people, and all the polluting works which were in the society, they were doing it. And these peoples were killing the untouchables. You had one particular chapter also, that is understood. Now these untouchables had to do all types of work in the society, and they were denied to go to the temples also there, and they were not getting the facilities which the high caste people were getting it. They were denied to take the water from the particular well where the upper caste people were taking it there. Even again, they had no right to bath that particular tank where the upper caste were taking bath there. Means such a discrimination was there. Means the caste discrimination was there. Even the men and the women discrimination were there. Understood? Women's status was so bad that women were not getting any type of rights in the society. First of all, when they were child, at that time only their father were doing their marriage and they had to go there in their lodge house there. But it means what the, and if within this time, this whenever these women were children and they married there, and in between if the husband died, they had no right to remarry also there. And in this chapter, we have to see such a social reform was came front to change the such a cruel systems from the society. Got it? So first point is there, working towards the change. Now here some many reformers came. Now they started to change the society. Got it? Now first of all, the discussion, debates were going on. So sometimes the writing, sometimes writing in the magazines, leaflets came out. Not only that, pamphlets also came out, and people could read what were such a cruel systems were there. Understood? Writing developed, and whenever the writing developed at that time, that people could understand whatever going in the society. Got it? Now see, in 7th standard you had learned about the manuscript. Manuscript were keeping it where in the archives there, and it was very much valuable. And it was written mostly in Sanskrit language, and only few people could read it. But these leaflets, this magazine, now this, they were writing in Prakrit language. These social reformers were there, they were writing in Prakrit language, and that's why most of the people could read it. Now these reformers could share their ideas, their emotions, everything by their writings there, and people could read it. So the social, political and religious developments happened in those days. Understood? Now see, within these many reformers, this Raja Ram Mohan Rai. This Raja Ram Mohan Rai was born in 1772 and reached what 1833. His death year is 1833. Now he had first of all written everything about such a blind belief, so social blind belief, superstition, and whatever the cruel systems were there in the society. Understood? And he thought that women, this widow women, must get right to remarry. And he said that not only the widow. Now he said that women's status in the society is very bad, and this word, they are humiliated by their families. Not only that, but they denied education also, and all types of works they have to do it where on in their family. Understood? So Raja Ram Mohan Rai, he was the scholar of Sanskrit, and just I told he born on 1772. He was a very clever. He knew all types of language, but Sanskrit he knew. He knew Sanskrit language, another European language also, that several Indian language also he had learned. Means he had learned all types of languages there, and he read all types of books there. Whenever he read at all types of book at that time, he came to understand in not any Vedic text had been written about the sati customs there. So he had published his article there that sati, this cruel system must be stopped. Understood? And he thought that people must have to use the news and new ideas. The people must have to give the education to the women. And he was the first social reformer there. And afterwards, another also followed him. Another was that was the Ishwarchandra Vidyasagar. He also followed to Rajaram Mohan Roy. After that, he also opposed to that such a cruel customs there, and he said that it is he also made the organization, and he also told that this widow can be married also there, and that's why he had written many letters to the East India Company or British government, and there one law passed in 1856 that is the widow could be married there. But only the law happened there. But if any widow had done the married there, then what that couple would not be respected in the society there. That's why many of the peoples were what they were fearing also there. But Ishwarchandra Vidyasagar and another that Telugu reformer that Veerasangar Patel, whenever this widow remarry, that concept spread up everywhere there. At that time, this Tamil Veerasangar Patel, he also had came front and he also told to that. Another, this Dayanand Saraswati also there, and he had get the Brahmo Samaj. That Dayanand Saraswati who founded the reform association called Arya Samaj. Now Dayanand Saraswati called Arya Samaj, and afterwards that another reformers were there, and these reformers have made that there such a many organization, and they had opposed to the cruel customs sati, and that is there, and they had tried to give the equal status to the women in the society. Another is what that Swami Dayananda Saraswati, just I told that he made the Arya Samaj also, and this the many such reformer were there. They had made the organization and tried to spread up equality in the society. Got it? Now in the first part we had seen this one. Now we will see the next lesson next topic in the second part. Understood? Till you have to read, and if you are curious, you can ask me. Thank you, my children.